I can't take no loss, huh. I don't even know what it costs, huh. I hit the ground then it go off, yeah. Hit the ground then it go off, yeah. I can't take no loss, huh. I don't even know. Hi and welcome back to The Conscious Day Trader. I'm Yanis and today we're going to break down a trade on the DAX ICT concept, London Open. Someone had asked, can you please do indices? And here we are. We're in Denmark, so this is not the normal setup and the not normal microphone. So hopefully you can work with this. But from the 20th, we'll be back into my sort of studio where I have my good sound and everything. So we're going to jump on to what was the trade today. We made 500 and let's have a look. $526. So good day. Only two trades, so a bit of a sniper approach, and this is the 5%ers. So we're going to jump on to the trading view where we're going to analyze how I got my bias, how I found the entry, the execution, and why on earth am I trading short after we've had 9 candles since daily candles since January 3rd going long on the pound. So what we're going to do, I want to remove everything and show you exactly what I saw this morning, because I looked at it fresh around the pre-open of the London session, and we're going to take away any replays. This is live information. And as you can see, that red candle is what I traded this morning. So we're going to start with, like anything, we're going to look at the previous daily high and the previous daily low. We're going to put those in. And I like putting them with a horizontal ray. And we're going to put the magnet on so we can definitely connect to the previous daily high. And I change this to my daily high. And then underneath, we'll go for the previous daily low. And we want to find the equilibrium. And equilibrium is where the price would, where the price has from the previous day and previous low, the 50% mark. And that would give us an idea, like ICT says, where the price is at discount or at premium price from the previous day. You can also put that in certain moves. If you want to do the high of the week and the low of the week, then you can see the discount price or the premium price of the week. But I like doing the daily. And there we have it. That's our arena. And what else do we need to look at the daily? We need to put our buy side liquidity and our sell side liquidity. Obviously, this has been a sustained move to the upper side. What has it been hunting? These areas here. And why? If we look at the price since the 5th of January, it came down, retested, filled in fair values and continued down. Okay. And it hit this low of the 118 area, and actually is spot on to 1180. If you look at that, that's why round numbers are very important. If I put that line on. Let's see how close it is. 108.09, so very close to that 800. That's telling me that's where the market wanted to find that bottom area. And we had a break of structure on the top here. We had a clean break of structure. This candle here is a lot bigger than any other candle in the long side before this area on the 9th of March. So a very significant move to the upper side, which took out these equal highs here. So what we'll do is just build the chart, and we'll take the magnet out. And obviously this was a buy side liquidity. Something I want you to pay attention towards is this area here. This drop here and this gap, someone would say that's a fair value gap. And you would be right. And it came and filled that fair value gap up to this point, continued lower. That would have been a really good trade. And then it came up, filled that fair value gap and continued lower. Now, why would this trade not do the same? You can find some small fair value gaps here. But as you can see, we had a swing high and it broke the swing high, not convincingly, But that's a convincing break, and it filled these areas here. And someone would say, oh, this candle is filling up this area, fair value gap, to continue lower. You would be correct, but what you would need to see is a break of structure on the lower structure. So you would need to this move here to fill, and then to give you a structure on the lower part. And it gave you that here. So someone might have gone short on this, and you would have your stop here. But what was filling up is, if your bias was long, what you would find is that this break here got filled this fair value gap to the pip. And if we zoom in, we've got this clean candle from wick to wick, this fair value area. And you can see exactly to the pip. It's incredible how many times it does that. So this would have been an amazing opportunity to go long. Why? Because we've got this high here, which is equal highs to this here. So we have resting buy side liquidity above these equal highs from that base there to that base there. So this is a very clean buy side liquidity which the market would want to go and take out. And as you can see, it did, it came up. It pushed even higher and came up to the top of the bottom of these areas here, where sell side liquidity was previously resting below these areas here. And we'll change that to sell side liquidity. And what that means is, for the people that were going long, they would be trailing their stops here, taken out, and then so on. So that would be a previous move, just so you have a generic idea of how you find the buy side and sell side liquidity. But that's historical data. So what's happening now? This move took out this high, and where would be the next target would be on the top of this side here. But that is quite far away. And as we mentioned earlier, so we have a lot of areas where the market, so this did get taken out, so we can take that out. And this did get taken out. So now we're in this arena with areas of taking these highs out all the way to the equal buy side liquidity here. How many pips is that? And if we look at the measurement, we're on a daily. So that is a big move. That's 1,000 pips on the top there. So 9%. That's not happening anytime soon. So what may happen, what would be the next target is, if that is the target and going long on the DAX, we would see a retracement to fulfill a better price going long. And those areas are provided with the fair value gaps of this move, of this seven candle here. So we've got buy side, we've got a fair value gap there, and we also have this order block here, which would be attracted for the price to come back to. And what that means is we had a sustained buying, and then the order block closed. At the bottom of that, we would have a fair value gap. So if we click that, add the fair value gap, we also have a fair value gap from the top of the order block to that area there. The more you do this, the more you see them with a clean chart. So here there's no fair value gap. Here there's no fair value gap. And there's a fair value gap right there from wick to wick. And that means that the candle on the right and the left is not fulfilling the order of this push candle on the upper side. So those are the areas of interest. So if we drag an arrow, let's do this one. The price would want to fill these areas down here. That's the idea. And we are, so for this to happen, what we want to see is the price to go higher, because we want to get as premium price as possible. And we want to have a good opportunity, risk reward, if you want, that our stop is not a lot of pips away if we are wrong, if this is going to continue higher. So I was biased short this morning. And what we would do is, and this is for the day, then what we'll go is the 15 minute and see how we found the trade to trade this short. And I will put the replay in just for convenience. And you'll see now it's on the 16th of January, 12 o'clock Denmark time. And let's go to the open. This is the London time. So if I go back to when I start looking at the graph, it was around 8 o'clock. And what we're seeing is a break of structure on the lower side. You might not see it on the 15 minutes, but what has the market done? I'll add the sessions on just so you can see where we are with the previous FX market sessions. So that will show me the New York and the London kill zone that I've imported. And what we see is that between the New York and London, which is the Asian market, the price went all the way up and took away the previous daily highs. Now we're at a super, at this top end here, super premium price for where the price were averaged for the previous sessions. So I was happy to take this short. What I needed to see was a break of structure. If I was awake at this time and I was down in the 2 minute chart, you would have received a break of structure with these waves down. But the most convincing break of structure was this here during the London Open. And we can see that on the 2 minute, and we can see it on the 1 minute. So we've come down from the previous daily high, and we've broke these previous lows, and we're hunting that equilibrium, bringing back the price from a premium to a discounted area. And what would we look in? I want to put a, actually, if I change the replay so we see this. So that's the break of structure during the open. And every minute, every 5 minute candle on this one, after this close, it created the fair value gap that would give me an opportunity to short the market. And we'll put that as a fair value gap. So as high as the price comes up here, I was more confident. I wanted it to come as high as possible so I can get a better price and trade it down to equilibrium. And I believe I got quite a good fill in the top end, close to the top end of that area here. My stop was above this order block here on the green candle. So a few pips, 10 pips, and I was looking for 30 to 40 pips going down. So that continued, and we had that area there. I didn't close. At this stage, I was about 150 in profit. And when we went down and hit that equilibrium, I took my position out for a $300. That's my first position here, $304 in profit. After that, because it was the first time of trading the DAX, I wanted to see how it reacted and how the price reacted to the fair value gaps, and what would it do after becoming discounted. I took the trade off here, and as you can see, then we had an even lower trade, but then it started coming back up into what would be the second fair value gap. And if you can't see it, like ICT says, pause the video and have a look where it is as a learning opportunity. But I'm sure you haven't done that, so I'll show you where the next fair value gap is, right there. And it delivers that really, really nicely, which it makes me quite interested in indices. So I might start trading indices a bit more, because it was very clean this morning, this trade. Touched the fair value gap and continued down back into equilibrium. And I killed the trade there for another 221.80. So two trades, super happy with that. And as we can see, then the price went back into premium. And now if I take away the replay, it's come back up to the top area of fair value. So it's filled the fair value fully. And we're trading in a premium price again. And you're waiting to see what would happen with the next candle. Indices have worked really well with ICT during the London Open. I know that ICT himself trades the NASDAQ, the S&P heavily this time and is staying away from Forex. I've been trading Forex, the pound USD, and keeping an eye on the dollar index and doing the analysis. I'm sure you've followed that. Please make sure you like this video and subscribe to the channel, because I really want to build this and do live trades. Also, we're doing the trading mindset that's coming up, which we're interviewing successful traders around the mindset and how to become a successful trader. What are tools can you use to break through the subconscious and the conscious thinking of not being good enough to get these numbers and trade like making half a grand a day and repeating this daily and improving yourself as a trader. So make sure you like this video, you subscribe, and I'll catch you. I'm hoping to trade a little bit more. We'll see, depending on time. We're on holiday, so don't expect a lot of trading. But so far, I have had some good trading opportunities from Denmark. And we'll see you hopefully tomorrow, or if not, we're very, very soon back in Italy, where we'll be trading from the studio. Hope you enjoyed it. Catch you later. I can't take no loss. I don't need no